On another occasion, a group of non-Muslims is invited to sit down with the circle. The preacher promotes Islam to them, but talks politely about other religions too.
And the message, the Quran, came to confirm the truth in the previous scriptures.
But as soon as the interfaith group leaves, the same preacher's tone changes completely. She now says Christian teachings are vile.
And we feel nothing sometimes going past the church. We don't look at it in disgust and think, subhanAllah, what are these people doing in there? What they say with their tongues is so vile and disgusting. It's an abomination.
Like the other preachers in the circle, she says she's teaching from the works of the Saudi scholars. In this case, Sheikh Bin Baz, a former Grand Mufti of the kingdom. The teachings include that a Muslim cannot be tolerant of other religions.
He shouldn't just be indifferent and say things like, you go to church, you know, I go to the mosque. Let's all stay together like one big happy family and all be united as humanity. This is false. This does not work. This concept is a lie. It's fake and it's a farce.
The circle preaches for 8 hours a day on Saturdays and Sundays. Any woman who goes there to pray is likely to hear their preaching. Our reporter has told the circle was set up years ago by Mira. But while she's been in Saudi Arabia, it's been run by this woman, Salim. She too preaches Saudi teachings. She says she's met a Muslim woman who is too friendly to non-Muslims.
When she sees a Kafir woman, big smile. When she turns around, she sees me there.
Yeah. It's part of Islam, of the aqid, of the correct belief, that you love those who love Allah and that you hate those who hate Allah. Okay?
The one who changed his deen, what we're going to do, is keep. Keep.
The last day will not come until the Muslims fight the Jews and kill them.
Our reporter, a Muslim herself, is going undercover in the most important and influential mosque in the country. London's Central Mosque, an Islamic cultural center, usually known as Regent's Park Mosque, says it promotes tolerance and interfaith. We featured it in last year's dispatches, and the mosque promised to crack down on anyone promoting extremism on its premises. So she's going back to find out if they've been true to their word. Women aren't allowed in the main hall, so she's directed upstairs to the main women's section on a large balcony overlooking the hall. Hundreds of women and children come here to pray every day. Then the congregation gathers in a large circle. The teacher today is Amira. She says she's teaching from a book by Sheikh Fazan, a senior member of the official Saudi religious establishment.
This is very, very good.
She starts with a revision session on what should happen to people who break Islamic laws, including Muslims who convert to another faith.
But he's Muslim and he get out of Islam. He doesn't want any more. What are we going to do? Kill.
You understand? We're talking about Islam. Yeah?
It's the same for adulterers.
For the had the zina, what is the law of this? Until he died. And the one who is not married,
The worshippers, many of whom are children or teenagers, are being taught the Saudi Arabian interpretation of Sharia law from official Saudi books. The teachings include the brutal killings of homosexuals and women who act like men.
If someone makes themselves like a man, a woman like a man, you understand this, the punishment is kill. Kill them from the highest place. And not going to be like animals, living like animals. Or to be like the people of Lord, we have to take the had. Had is to kill them.
This causes a brief debate among the young students. One girl says they should also be stoned.
With the punishment of, you know, throw them from the highest point.
Another student says the punishment is approved by the Quran. Yeah.
Then we reduced him to the lowest of the low. So if you throw someone up a mountain, you are reducing him to the lowest of the low because they're falling off from a high
cliff. Condemns terrorism and says these punishments will only be carried out in a future Islamic state under a Muslim leader, not in present-day Britain. This fundamentalist interpretation of Islam is being taught in Britain's most important and supposedly moderate mosque. Our reporter finds out where Umma Mira has been trained. She says she's just finished 3 years of study at Medina Mosque in Saudi Arabia. It's the second most holy mosque in Islam, and its imams teach Muslims an interpretation of the faith known to some as Wahhabism. Umma Mira teaches what she says is an important principle in Islam. A Muslim must hate as well as love.
It's not enough that you worship Allah, we have to also, in our heart, hate what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means to Allah and love what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
She says this principle relates to living with non-Muslims.
Hate what displeases to Allah, especially when living with this country that's non-Muslim.
And asks a worshipper to read out a verse from the Quran.
Stand up and raise peace.
Which she says is about relations between Muslims and non-Muslims.
Verily, we are free from you and whatever you worship besides Allah, we have rejected you and there has appeared between us and you hostility and hatred forever until you believe in Allah alone.
Umma Mira says it means Muslims must separate from non-Muslims.
You understand, sister? Islam is the tabarruk min shirk. Min shirk wa ahli, the people who do the shirk. Any questions?
After the lesson, our reporter approaches Umma Mira to ask her to clarify her teaching.
You know, when we talked about the love and enmity for Allah, how do we apply that? How is a Muslim do I apply that?
Yeah. Muslims should show good manners to non-Muslims and can try to convert them to Islam, but cannot befriend them. She uses the Arabic term kafir, meaning disbeliever or infidel.
To be a good friend, give them all about our secret, you know. Understand? But you have to be friendly with them. That is not allowed. Because wala is only to Muslim, not to the kafir.